Hello, Beta Nation. Welcome back to thaitybetta channel. This video is going to be the first in a series of do-it-yourself and advice and beta tips and knowledge from the inside. This video in particular, I'm going to show you how to make the only two types of filters that you need to know for betas or beta breeding, which are the sponge filters, which are the ones that take care of the microscopic stuff like the bad bacteriums and, you know, all the really tiny nasty things. And the other type is this type, which is more of a particle filter and actually gets like the bigger chunks of fish poop and leftover food and things like that. So I'm gonna give you a real brief but real detailed do-it-yourself video on how to make both of these. And again, these are the only two types of filters you'll ever really need to know regarding betas. And these are the best working ones. I've tried for over half a decade of making my own out of different materials and whatnot. And as far as how good they work and how cheap they are to make, these are bar none the best. So you got your particle filter, and then you've got your more biotype filter here. There's also a third type, I guess I can tell you about real quick, which are these glass chimneys. They have no bottom and no top. And you put an air stone down in the bottom of it and fill it with glass beads and glass pieces like this. And when you turn on the air stone and the bubbles run through it, it becomes a massive particle and biofilter. And it's excellent. It'll keep your tank nice and healthy and alive for years. So there's a bonus for you. Now you've got all three kinds. But you don't need that big kind of biofilter unless it's a big grow out tank like this, something you're going to have thousands and thousands of fry in. Otherwise, it's just overkill and not necessary. They look nice, but you don't really need it unless you're, you know, putting thousands of fry in them. So we're going to focus on the sponge filters, like these, and the particle filters, like these. This video is going to be a fast-forward version, so that the people who aren't actually making one while they're watching it don't want to blow their brains out from boredom. So if you're actually going to make this, just simply pause it while you're working your way through on the steps, and this should be real easy for you. So you have here basic supplies. You don't need all of this stuff. Some of this stuff just makes it a little easier. Got here some chopsticks. It needs to be a real sharp pen like this, real sharp point, or substitute it for a sharpened pencil. I would snap off the lead, make it real sharp, and then snap off the lead, because the lead will probably break off anyway. Small zip ties. Need lots of small zip ties if you're going to make lots of filters. You only really need one if you're just going to make the one. Scissors. We've got different pairs here. The smaller ones are actually best, but if you're stuck with a big household pair, that'll be fine. This is another major ingredient here, are these women's hair curlers things. I don't have a stand for my camera is another reason I'm doing this the way I'm doing it. I've got to hold this while I do it. So what you have is you have these women's foam rollers, right? And there's several different types of these. You need this kind, which are the double foam roller with one single hole drilled through it for this thing. Get rid of that, you don't need it. See here, you've got one hole in the middle in between the two. This is the kind you want. If it's the kind with the hole through the middle here instead of here, you don't want it. If the hole's in the middle of this foam, it's no good. It's got to be this kind, or no hole at all is just fine. If it's a single one, that's fine, but it can't have a hole. I've never said that before in my life. Okay, so these double ones like this are the ones that you have to have. Again, this is trash, you don't need it anymore, just get rid of it. Sorry, I've got a big mess going on here. The other thing you're gonna need are these gravel rocks. Color is up to you. I would suggest getting a color that matches your beta. Like if you've got a turquoise, green, or blue one, these are colors you want. If you've got a red one, I'd suggest red and black rocks. But try to match the color of your rocks to the color of your beta, and it makes a big difference as far as visual appeal. especially with an accent light on it, it'll really make a difference in any room.
Okay, so other than that, the only two other things you're going to need are, you don't need one of these thermometers. I'm just showing you these because the suction cups that come with these thermometers are the suction cups you need. They're really cheap. You can buy a backup pair at most of your fish pet stores. You know, you get a little backup pack of like three of the suction cups only for like $1.50. The actual thermometer itself with one of the suction cups is pretty cheap too. It's a couple bucks. I think it's like $3 or something. So you need that suction cup. Again, they're really cheap, really easy. Just get the ones with the rubber ring on the back of them that are made for those thermometers for fish tanks, and you'll be good to go. The other thing you're going to need are these condiment jars, like so. Mayonnaise, mustard, ketchup. This is mustard, mayo, ketchup. You don't need these if you're just doing the sponge filter, but you are going to need them if you're going to do the canister particle filter, which is this filter right here. If you're going to make one of these instead of one of these, then you need some sort of condiment jar. These ones work the best, and I've tried a lot of different ones, so try to get your hands on these. They're not that hard to find. You can even find arts and crafts stores, maybe even Walmart has weird little glass condiment containers like that. So get yourself as many of those for however many filters you're planning on building. What I did here, because I don't have a free hand, is I'm using this wrench with a pin stuck in it, so that gives me more freedom here. So the first thing you got to do is you want to take this, you want to take your scissors, and you want to cut right down the middle and cut this into two, okay? Just as close to right down the middle as you can get it. So what you'll have left are these two pieces. Then you see these ridges here, you're just going to take your scissors and cut those off, trim those off nice and smooth, flush with the canister shape. Something like that. You know, it's a lot better than it was. I'd take the time to make it perfect, but I don't want to make you wait. So then what you do is you take this, your sponge. You want to get the tip of your pen right in the middle of that, and then you want to pull it down. You want to use two hands. You want to grip down here on the bottom. Sorry, my hands are so dirty. I'm in the middle of working with a bunch of stuff. But use two hands, grab it down here on the ends, and just pull it down, and it'll feed its way through. If it's having a hard time, grab your pair of scissors and just barely open the blade about that much. Stick it in the tip and open and close it a couple of times, and it'll make the opening hole you need to get it in there. Then you want to pull this down about 3/4 of the way. Do not go all the way to the top. If you did, you ruined it, and you might as well have just bought one that had a hole in it to begin with, because those won't work. The hole does not go all the way through. It goes about 3/4 of the way. I'm going to stop now and continue this in part two. It won't be much longer. This took a while, a lot longer than I thought, but we're almost finished. Stay tuned for part two.